It's Wednesday. It's Wednesday. What you got on it? It's what you got on it Wednesday. We live. We live. It's what you got on it Wednesday. Welcome, welcome. Thank you for coming. It's what you got on it Wednesdays. So excited to be here tonight. Thank you everybody who joined me last night for that awesome conversation with Mama Duke. I appreciate you for joining me. Welcome to What You Got On It Wednesday. We're going to have some fun tonight. We're going to talk about some of my favorite films of 2020. Basically, what I got on it is what you should be watching. If you haven't watched it, I want to share. If you have watched it, I'd love to hear what you thought of the films. Kind of have a little rewind of 2020 film style, right? So share with you some of the films that I watched while I was in the process of working on this film, working on building the production, budget, you know, throughout this process, like what I've been looking at, what I've been drawing on for inspiration, or just like just trying to watch to escape a bit, right? You know, I'm a big film head. I love to watch movies. And I recently was on an amazing podcast called Boy Meets Wellness. And one of the questions that I was asked on that podcast was, what was my top three? And I was just racking my brain. Like, I don't know if I have three. I definitely did share some of these films that I'm going to share tonight on that podcast. But I had to give myself some time to think like, okay, what are my top five films of 2020? So I appreciate Evolve for bringing me on to Boy Meets Wellness to talk about the film. If you haven't gotten the chance to tap into that podcast, I really hope that you do. I want to share a little bit from that interview if you all don't mind checking it out. Welcome to the live. It's what you got on it Wednesdays. Thank you for coming. I see you, Jessica. Thank you for joining. Thank y'all for joining me for What You Got On It Wednesday. So that was the clip from the podcast for Boy Meets Wellness. I was on there on Friday. Just wanted to share a little bit of that. Because that podcast episode had me thinking like, okay, what are my top films? Like what films that I feel like really spoke to me? And I wanted to share those with you. So without further ado, we about to just hop into the top five films that I absolutely enjoyed this year. 2020 was a very difficult year. I thought this would be a good opportunity to kind of talk about some of the things that, either brought me joy, you know, uplifted my spirit during this time, helped me kind of push through this year to make it to see my 33rd birthday, right? It was really challenging, I'm sure. It was really challenging, excuse me, for myself. And I'm sure other people can also attest to the challenge that it's been this year. But let's just do it. Let's just put whatever you can on helping me make retros today for What You Got On It Wednesday. You can click the link in my bio. The GoFundMe is live and open, and we are accepting your love offerings, if you know what I mean. Say yeah in the chat. Let me see where you at. Ah, thanks for the love. Thanks for the love. Okay, so first film that I want to get into that I absolutely love this year. I know a lot of you all watched it on Disney Plus. First film had to be, absolutely, without a doubt, Black is King. Okay, Black is King from Beyonce, Giselle Knowles Carter was everything. Everything for me. Like, from the top to the bottom, I would just turn on Disney Plus and just turn on Black is King, clean the house. You know what I'm saying? Watch Black is King intently when I was just bored and just wanted something to watch to make me feel good, to make me get up and start dancing. Because it was sometimes a lot where I was just like, I don't want to move. I'm just going to sit on this couch and I'm not going anywhere. I would turn on Black is King and all of a sudden just, oh, shit. Right? Water had to be one of my favorite, I feel like that's the name of the song, video. I mean, that... I don't know what it was, a giant staircase with that long hair. I mean, aesthetically beautiful, seeing Pharrell in that overall situation with the bandana. Loved it. I was here for it, here for the storytelling. I love that there were so many different artists that I was being put on in that video, excuse me, in that film, rather. She did a great job. Kudos to Disney Plus for rolling that out the way that they did. They knew what they was doing, and I appreciate that, and I appreciate them. Yeah, so for me, Black is King, absolutely number one. I know I said this was not going in order, but I guess I sort of, kind of, slightly am a bit going in order with this. Okay, so number two for me of my top five films of 2020, top five films of 2020. And these are films that we mostly, I don't know about you all, but I watched from the comfort of my home. When I was looking at my list, I was like, wow, all of these films were films that I didn't go to the theater to see, which is really strange for me because I am a theater head. Like, I go to the movie theater, matinees, evening times, like double headers. I am a theater goer. So to have all of my top five films be films that I saw that weren't in theaters really kind of made me like sit back and say, maybe the theater is not going extinct, but maybe it's not as necessary as I thought it was. But definitely Black is King on my top of my top five list. Okay, next on my top five list. Yes, the Clark sisters, First Lady of Gospel on Lifetime. I'm gonna give those producers all of their things. Hold on, I knew I was gonna be more prepared and have their names, and please forgive me, I don't offhand. I know Queen Latifah, Missy Elliott, I wanna say Carter. I'm gonna pull it up shortly, but the Clark sisters, First Lady of Gospel. Amazing biopic, one of my favorite biopics in the past 10 years. The acting, superb. Some of those actresses were first actors, I'm just calling them actors, right? That's gender. Some of those folks were first time actors, right? Amazing job. Like, they brought their souls to that to that film, to the roles. I felt it. Since that time, I've just been in a Clark sisters like run, like just deep tracks. So shout out to Lifetime for that film, putting that out and giving us access to it for a really long time. I feel like it still might be on if you have Lifetime streaming. You still might be able to stream it. If you can, please go watch this film. Go watch it. It is amazing. The singing, the songs, the costumes. If this film doesn't get its awards, I am going to be tight. I am going to be tight because it absolutely deserves every single award. It was a phenomenal cast. Definitely best ensemble musical category. Phenomenal job. My favorite characters had to be... I'm gonna give it to her. Kiki did her thing. Okay, Kiki played her mama, okay, as only a daughter could, right? I love the casting because, truth be told, who gonna play you better than your child, okay? The little human that sees all of your nuances, right, can bring that to life. And the singing, like I said before, tens across the board. It was the best. These are my top five films of 2020. I've already said my first one for those just joining. First one was absolutely Black is King. Kudos to Beyonce. Giselle knows Carter, first of her name. Next up is definitely going to be the Clark Sisters, First Ladies of Gospel. Phenomenal film. If you haven't seen it, please go see it. It was a great movie. All right. Shouts out to all the documentary heads in the live right now. We're watching this replay. A Secret Love. This came up, I believe, on my Twitter timeline one night. A really great friend of mine, Campbell X, he posted about it, and I said, if Campbell's talking about it, if they're saying it's something, I might have to dive in. So popped into A Secret Love that was on Netflix. Tear jerker, okay? Be prepared for the floods to come, all right? Be prepared with your tissues. It's a great good cry, right? And I believe folks might say that about The Notebook. That's how I felt about A Secret Love. Such a beautiful story. That couple, they are so good on camera. So their chemistry just came across. Like, I was watching the film like, okay, this is how they stayed together for all these years. Because I'm like, how can you spend all this time with one person? Man, when I saw them interacting, I was just like, oh, okay. I get it. It's a great film. If you like documentaries, if you love love stories, if you are in for a good romantic, I think it's a romantic comedy. And some people might be like, what? For me, the comedic elements were so well placed. They hit at the right time. It's a great film that pulls at your heartstrings for sure. A Secret Love on Netflix. Once again, another film that better get its tings. Okay, it better get its tings. I was in a documentary. I was in a documentary zone. So another documentary that you should watch this 2020. I highly recommend it. I'm not biased because I helped work on it. You know, I did a sound fellowship through that film. I'm just saying it's a great documentary. Please go watch Disclosure on Netflix. It's a phenomenal film. Great group of folks that I was able to work with. And it's just a film that I feel like everybody needs to see. It's one of those everybody, it's standard. Like that's a film that you need to watch. So go check out Disclosure on Netflix right now. Like I said before, a lot of these films on my list for the top five films of 2020 are films that I did not see in the movie theater. These are films that I'm just, shit, how do I get through this pandemic, you know? I was feeling, from about April to June, I was feeling down bad. And A Secret Love came through with the feels that I needed. Disclosure as well. Black is King. These are some films that really uplifted my spirit and just made me escape, right? Made me just go to another place, right? To be able to experience this love story between these two beautiful women from Canada who had, you know, a secret love affair their entire lives together, adult lives together. I was just like, wow, like, okay, I want to watch this. I'll escape. Take me to Canada. Okay, I know the border is closed right now, so take me over. So I was doing a lot of this and then also watching a lot of House Hunters International. Shouts out to everybody that be watching HGTV during the pandemic. All right, so coming at number three for all my folks, what's cracking, Mama Duke? Please go up just. Hey, shouts out to Mama Duke just dropping the album cover. I'm definitely gonna check it out. I know you said your wifey created that album cover. I'm definitely checking it out. Appreciate it. Appreciate the love. So number three on my list for all my horror heads, you know, had to put this on a list. His House on, again, Netflix. His House is a wonderful film. If you like horror, if you like a thriller, you know, if you're into ghosts, aberrations, what else? Scary shit. Watch His House on Netflix. I thought it was a phenomenal film. It wasn't too long. It got to its points. It definitely got some great scares. I know I love to watch it with my partner. She was jumping and grabbing me, and it was just like, oh, okay. You know, you don't have to be in the theater to still get that feel, right? You can get that good scare from this film at home, on your couch, chilling at the crib, by yourself, or maybe in your pod with your pandemic pod. But you should definitely watch His House. It stars some really talented actors, and I highly recommend it. I would say this is an international film. Yeah, this is an international film. So I've got some international films on this list. I've got some docs on this list. I've got, Black is King is also an international film. No Tino Shade, Beyonce, I love you. Definitely a lot of great films made all over the globe this year. Appreciate that. Appreciate you for joining me for What You Got On It Wednesday. Oh, my bro is in the house. Shouts out to my big brother in the house. We talking about our favorite films. These are films that I also ran by all my homies. So my brother knows these movies because I told him, make sure every time we talk, I'm like, make sure you go watch this movie. Make sure you go watch this movie. If you know me, you know that in a phone conversation or in some type of conversation, I'm gonna put you on to a movie or a series or something that I'm watching that I enjoy, that I love. For you all that have just joined, I'm going to just run through the quick lineup so far of our top five films of 2020, meaning our, meaning mine, my top five films of 2020. If you're just now joining me, I appreciate you for being here. Thank you so very much. I love you all. And hey, we having fun with that one. How many of you are digging this background? No, we're not into it. Okay. Program, and that's how we move on it. Yeah, we'll just go back to none. Thank you all for joining me for What You Got On It Wednesday. Sir Lex Kennedy, thank you all for coming in. So far, we've had the Clark Sisters, the First Lady of Gospel. That was my number two film. Black is King is definitely my number one film. A Secret Love Story came in at number three. His House came in at number four. What's up, Michaela? Shouts out to my best friend in the building. Shouts out to the Sag in the building. Birthdays on the way. What you know, God damn it. If you a Sagittarius and you watching What You Got On It Wednesday right now, shout yourself out. You know, I'm trying to be PC. Shout yourself out. I know it's cool on the East Coast, so I'm trying to bring in that warm energy, them great vibes, trying to give you some great films to watch to keep you warm. You know, you might be in the crib for a little while, snowed in or whatnot. So while you're in the crib, make sure you check out a great action film called The Old Guard, starring Charlize Theron. That's also on Netflix. It was directed by Gina Price Bryfoot. Listen, kudos. Let black women direct things, yeah? Give black women and femmes their things. Give black femmes their things and get out the way. Provide the budget, you feel me? Give them the talent, you feel me? And watch what happens. Great film. This film has one of my favorite scenes of any film of the year. Like if I broke down, my top five scenes of the year, this film would definitely have my number one favorite scene of the year. If you know, you know. If you've seen this film, you probably know the scene I'm talking about. Super amazing, great, talented cast. I love the story. I enjoyed the action. All in all, great film. I can't wait to see the next one because you know it's a good action film. So you know we're gonna get some more, right? This is just the origin story, and I loves me an origin story. Speaking of origin stories, shouts out to all of you all for watching this, because our origin story, I believe somebody talked about it on Twitter recently, said something about how black folks will be tapping into our true DNA and doing things that we only thought were fictional on December 21st. So shouts out to y'all. We about to turn into a whole real live action movie, okay? I don't know about you, but I'm already putting together my outfit and I'm already calling in the powers that I want. I hope that you're also calling in your powers. And I'm charging up your crystals because it's on, okay? And if you've seen The Old Guard, I'm trying to tell you, we about to be coming back. Okay, I don't want to get too much in the movie, but we're going to just be able to... Oh, you thought. We back. What you thought wasn't going to happen. You feel me? No weapon formed against us, okay? But... if you are watching this, I appreciate you. This is me sharing my top five films of 2020 here on What You Got On It Wednesday. These are some of the films, like I was saying earlier, that I watched to get through this pandemic. I watched some of these films as I was writing and working on retros. These are films that really stuck to me and that I really wanted to tell folks about and kind of hear what you all thought. So that's my top five. I do want to give a few honorable mentions. Another one. It's got to be Becoming. Please Believe, Becoming. I mean, hello. I'm a documentarian at my core. No, I'm just joking. I just love docs. Documentary storytelling is great. And Michelle Obama is amazing. And it was a great watch. I enjoyed watching it. I enjoyed hearing her talk about this book. I watched it like, okay, well, let me get the... Hello. Let me just crack it open. It was a great film. Also on Netflix. Do we have any other honorable mentions? I also talked about Disclosure. Again, another documentary on Netflix. Netflix. No tea, no shade. Netflix is really trying it. Raising their prices. I don't know about y'all, but I just got put onto a new app. And I'm cut. Well, I'm just... Okay, well, I don't pay the Netflix bill, you know what I'm saying, in the household. But I'm still like, man, Netflix, you tried it, okay? But I do want to put you on some tea because my best friend, shouts out to you, KJ, put me onto this app. And I'm just trying to share the love. Go download Pluto TV. Okay, that's Pluto, like the planet, TV. Tap into all of that free content. Tap into all of that free streaming content. I've been watching Showtime at the Apollo for the past 4 or 5 days. Getting my life, you hear me? I'm talking Showtime at the Apollo, hosted by Sinbad, Showtime at the Apollo. You feel me? Okay, get into it. Pluto TV app, this is not an ad. I'm just putting you all on the game because Netflix is $15? Maybe it's not $15. That's how you know I don't pay it. But I am cutting the cord with Apple Music because I can watch YouTube for free. Like all this music, it's on YouTube. So I'm like, why am I paying Apple if I can get it on you? Sorry, y'all. That's going to be for next week. Next week, I'm going to get into my top five albums. So top five albums of 2020. Albums that made me go, hey, or just got me in a groove. You know, the albums that really just helped me pushed through my things. That's going to be next week for What You Got On It Wednesday. So essentially, I'm going to close out the rest of 2020 with a series of top fives, right? Tonight, I'm talking about my top five films. Black is King. His House, yes. I had to think about it. I was like, stop. Think about it. The Clark Sisters, the First Ladies of Gospel Music. The Old Guard. And Secret Love. Those are my top films of 2020. So next week, we'll do my top albums. And then after that, I'll do my top sneakers and tennis shoes. So if you a sneakerhead, I hope that you tap in. I hope to have a special guest to come on and join me and talk about the top sneakers of 2020. So next week, we'll do top 20 albums, right? R&B, hip-hop, rap, alternative, R&B, hip-hop, rap. Oh, that's kind of like where I'm staying. That's like the lane. And then after that following week, we'll do the top five sneakers, top five kicks of 2020. So excited for these upcoming What You Got On It Wednesdays. Please donate to Retros by tapping the link in my bio. We've got the GoFundMe that just launched last week. So this is like the hard push, the spread, the push to my larger audience. Folks, I am so excited about making this film. I'm so grateful to the folks who have donated so far. I really appreciate you all. I really love you all. I'm really, really grateful to be able to share this space and this energy with you. This has given me purpose every day to get up and get on it, right? Because I know that I can make my dreams happen because I have a wonderful supporting core of family, right? Family. That love me and that will support me and that want to see me do well. So I appreciate you all. I'm so grateful. Top five films of 2020. Drop it in the comments when I post this, you know, when it goes live on the post. Make sure you come back and tell me, what were your top five films? Did you agree with me? Did you watch any of these films? I appreciate my big brother for joining me and stopping in. I love you, Carl. I love you so much. Shouts out to you, Michaela. Shouts out to all the Sagittarius in the motherfucking building. It's Sag season. Happy birthday. Hey, happy holidays. Happy Hanukkah to everyone celebrating. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Mercrim. I love you all. I love you so much. This is what you got on it Wednesday. I am Sir Lex Kennedy, and I just want to say I appreciate you, and I will see you next week on What You Got On It Wednesdays. We'll be talking about the top 5 albums of 2020. I love us.